seen better days. Yeah, in my soul you penetrate. I need your energy. Yeah, vibrations make me levitate. Sipping Hennessy, reading bell hooks. She just saying,
I am surprised you don't.
Welcome to the new sounds of the Center of the SOHL podcast, brought to you by the SOHL Center, the Center for Self, Health, and Wellbeing. I am your urban luminary, your master healer, your certified well-being expert and best-selling author, Master Omaka. Thank you for joining. Thank you for tuning in, and thank you for downloading the new podcast. We are here to bring a new sound to you, a new energy, a new wave, a new thought pattern, a new way of thinking and living. This is a new message, a new me. And I just want to introduce you to the Center of the SOHL podcast, where we will be talking about nothing but the greater things of holistics, the way that we are tending to live holistically. How are we going to live holistically? Well, that's what the podcast is about. You're going to hear from so many great interviews, so many great luminaries, so many great teachers, so many great people in the field of holistics, in the field of self-health and well-being. And for the first show today, I just want to say that you are a part of a family. When you are at the SOHL Center, I want you to know that you are home. And when you're home with us, you're family. So we have a lot of things coming to you today, coming to you for the rest of the season. Now, the season that we're going to be presenting to you today by way of the SOHL Center is just that of how to live a more holistic life, how to join a family and become a member of the SOHL Center. This podcast is dedicated to you. And I mean dedicated. That means everything that we talk about will be dealing with how do you find yourself in a better space of living your life. Because what we're teaching here, what we're bringing here, what we're doing here is something that goes beyond study. It goes beyond education. It goes beyond even a teacher. This is where you will begin to have answers to questions you had for a very long time. So once again, thank you for tuning in. Thank you for showing up for you. And thank you for downloading the Center of the SOHL podcast. We want to get to the center of your soul. We want to encourage you and engage with you. So this is a podcast where you can leave your comments and I will see your comments. And we got so much in store from the Center of the SOHL podcast. We have so much in store with our first season, our first episode, and our first year together here. Podcast is just one of those things that is just a different dynamic. You get to hear the stories and use your own imagination and use your own visualization to know how to live better, to live holistically. We practice a lot of things at the SOHL Center, and some of those things we'll dive deep into as we go deep and further into the Center of the SOHL podcast. So thank you for joining. And keep your mind aware of what's to come from the Center of the SOHL podcast, because I guarantee it will be something that will start to change your life in a more positive and impactful way. Life experience is the best teacher, and you get a lot of life experience through the experiences of those who are coming to you, those who are teaching, those who are bringing you the message of living a holistic lifestyle. So thank you once again. I will begin to see you at our first episode on the other side, the mastery of building holistic relationships. Thank you for joining.
I'm dying on the moon, and I just need.
Maybe you are so unusual, like cutting cuticles, but that is just what makes you beautiful, like watching tulips grow. And when you walk, it's in slow motion, baby. Why you moving slow? And when you talk, I got my lasers on you like a UFO. Girl, your eyes are like the open sea, the simple poetry. This whole generation, OMG, I see your soul is older. We should build a city overseas. This country kinda cold. I mean, they feed the children dopamine and leave them on the sofa. I need someone to renounce with. Whoa, ice bucket challenge in a fountain. Whoa. chance of finding you one in 100,000. Whoa, whoa, I just wanna kiss you on a mountain. Whoa,
I might bend the rules, 'cause I'm in love with you.
Welcome back to the first episode of the Center of the SOHL podcast. I am once again your urban luminary, Master Omaka, certified well-being expert, best-selling author, healer, and poet, here to bring you a rendition of the SOHL Center. The SOHL Center is our space, our healing space, where you get to join us in holistic practices, building holistic relationships, and building holistic habits. One of the things that I love to do is talk all about well-being. I love to talk about how do we heal on a masterful level? How do we heal on a mastery level where our relationships are reflective of who we are? And I believe, being that this is our first episode today, I want to have you join me in a understudy of what this podcast will begin to do and be about mostly. It will be about how do we find a way to live holistically. Now, the relationships is something that we must know how to master. That's why I chose today for our first episode to be the mastery of building holistic relationships. Why is building holistic relationships so key, so detrimental to our well-being, to our whole self? Well, let's dive into that on a deeper level. So for those of you who are joining me here on the podcast, thank you. For those of you who decided to listen, you have downloaded the show. I want to thank you for that as well. And for those of you who subscribe, comment, and share the podcast, thank you. I ask that you continue to do so that we become known, we get this message out there, and people can become aware of who we are, where we are, and what we're doing. Going into what I want to talk about tonight is building holistic relationships, the mastery of building holistic relationships. This is where you're going to begin to believe in a practice of good habits. Good habits is what produces results. Results on another level. Results where when we are taking in what we are doing on a full aware level. What I mean by a full aware level is that we are aware of who we are. When we take in who we are, we become aware of that. Then can we build from the inside out? We can begin to build our relationships on a masterful level. Now, we have to master who we are first in order for the relationships to be reflective of who we are. So some of the things that we need to understand about who we are is that we are not just what we see. We are not what we see when we look in the mirror. We are not what we touch, what we sense in our senses. We are not what we smell. We are not what we hear. We are not the things that enter in. We are the things that exit out. What enters in is because of what exited out. Write that one down. What enters in is reflective of what exit out. And so we need to become aware of what exited out. What's exiting out? What is it that we're doing that is exiting out of our lives? And so we got to look at that. So how do we begin to look at that? Some may ask this question. Well, I am here to show you and teach you that. We got to understand that we are not who we believe we are and what we look in the mirror to see. And we're not who we believe that we are when we are looking at the world externally. We are experiencing the world on a surface external level. And we begin to believe that this is who we are internally. We are not who we believe we are on a external level. We are who we are on an internal level. The way we find that out, the way we uncover that, is beginning to believe and buy into what we are on the internal level. So I'm going to break that down. I hope you got your pens and your pads ready. So let's begin to look at that first. First of all, you are made up of five senses internally. Now, I always talk about this in my teachings in the, at the SOHL Center, is that we practice self-health and well-being. Well-being is key. Well-being is who we are on a spiritual, on a soulful level. So when we look at well-being, what are we talking about? Practicing a well-being lifestyle. Well, we're talking about our spiritual side, the spirit nature and who we are. So on a well-being level, we are creatures of what we're experiencing internally. So our habits are formed not from what we are experiencing externally. Our habits are formed from what we believe in what we are experiencing externally. But your habits can be shaped by your shifting in your mindset and what you believe you are internally. So here they are. You are made up, your well-being self, your whole self, the well-being part of you is made up of spirit, mental, emotional, physiological, biological. Now, we can spend all night breaking every one of these down to a minute level. But I want to go into how do we build holistic relationships from this part of ourselves. So when you are experiencing your external world through the five senses, sight, seeing, taste, touch, and smell, you need to know that you are experiencing your external world from who you are internally. So let's begin to break that down in who we are internally as far as our senses go. So in your spiritual side of you, your spirit nature, the spirit nature of who you are spirit once again. Now you are experiencing through the spirit your sense of smell. So you may be in a conversation or if you, let's do this. Let me create a visual scenario for you. You ever watch movies? A mob movie? A mobster movie? A mafia movie? You ever see mafia people or mobsters? When they talk about a rat being in the room or something doesn't feel right in a way, how do they address it? They say something like this. Something doesn't smell right. Or they would say something smells fishy. Or they would say, I smell a rat in the room. Now, you may smell a rat in the room, but you're not actually smelling a rat. This is, you know, so we got to understand, what do we mean when we say I smell a rat, or I smell something fishy? Something fishy is going on, or something doesn't smell right. Now, what does that mean? Does that mean something actually doesn't smell right? Absolutely not. When you say something doesn't smell right, what you're saying is what you are sensing through your spirit nature. Your spirit is your sixth sense in a way on an external level, because it's really one of your first senses on an internal level. But on the external level, your spirit is your sixth sense. And so when you say something doesn't smell right, or I smell a rat, or something smells fishy around here, what you're actually saying is your spirit is not agreeing with something in someone in your presence. Your spirit is not agreeing with someone in your presence or something that is physically present with you. So you are saying something doesn't smell right. So how do we create a holistic relationship through this? How do we create a how do we master relationships through the sense of our spirit? Well, you got to start becoming aware of who you are so that you are aware of who people are. If you are aware of who you are, you can become aware of who people are without having to know them on a physical level or on a natural level. You don't have to get to know people on a natural level to be like, oh man, I know this person. No. When you meet someone and you are spiritually aligned with that person, normally you say something like this. Man, it feels like I've known you forever. Yeah, because our spirits are connected. Our souls, everything is connected spiritually. And so our souls are experiencing a connection divinely. Our souls are experiencing a divine connection. And we can say things like, man, it feels like I've known you forever when I only met you 5 minutes ago. That's because our souls are connected on a spiritual level. And so we sense things on a spiritual level. So we begin to experience the external world through the sense of smell because we are experiencing on a spiritual level, not the sense of smell, but something in our spirit that smells good to us. Someone in our presence that smells good to us. So you can learn the first key of mastering holistic relationships is becoming more aware of yourself so that on a spiritual level, you know what feels right. You can understand, you can tell, and you can have a sense of what feels good to you, what smells right to your spirit. If there is a stench in the room, it's not because there's an actual stench from someone's physical presence. It's someone's spiritual presence that doesn't smell right to you. If you are walking around with a clean spirit, a pure spirit, then can you smell something that's impure? And so now you have an awareness of yourself spiritually, then you can tell if someone doesn't smell right to you. So you can build, you can master relationships off of this first principle. Learning how to sense through smell, but I'm not talking about on an external level, I'm talking about on a spiritual level. Through smell, through the sense of smell, through your spirit, you can master relationships, holistic relationships, being so keen and aware of who you are that you don't need to know someone on a yearly basis, a day-to-day basis, to say that you know this person. You can meet them 5 minutes ago and know that person. You can meet people and know who they are the moment you meet them because your spirit will not agree on a holistic level because you are in tune and in connection with who you are spiritually. And then you begin to sense from the spirit, you move on into your next external sense of building masterful relationships, holistic relationships, how to master holistic relationships. Become aware of who you are so you are keenly aware of who others are. Second, you start to move into emotion. And so, and there's no particular order to spirit, emotion, mental, physiological, and biological. I'm just going through these for you so you know them. This is just the outlines of how you learn who people are. And so on an emotional level, you begin to experience other people on an emotional level through sight. So your sight is how you experience people emotionally. If you don't believe me, let's create another visual scenario for you where I can tell you how you are experiencing emotion, your internal state of well-being, your internal state of being, which is emotion, one of them being emotion. You are experiencing through sight. You're experiencing the world around you through sight emotionally. So how do we do that? How are we experiencing people through our sight emotionally? Well, let's create a scenario for you. Let's say you are in a relationship with a guy or a girl, whoever, and you are out one day and your significant other, your partner, your lover, your spouse, your husband, your wife, your fiance, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, whomever this person is, your partner, whomever this person is to you. What happens if you see this person out with someone else? You begin to experience this sense of jealousy on an emotional level. So you walk up to your lover and you say, who is this person you're with? What are you doing with them? Who is this girl? Who is this guy? Who is this person that you're with? Are you cheating on me? Well, listen, you may not know the dynamic of that connection. You may not know the dynamic of that relationship that you're seeing, but because of what you're seeing, you are experiencing it emotionally. And then you begin to say, who this person is, why are you with this person, who is this person that you're with? You're experiencing life on an emotional level through sight, through what you see. How is this and why is this important? Because, beloved, if you want to build holistic relationships, you can stop yourself from jumping to conclusions, assuming things, if you get the full breadth and understanding of what is going on in your world around you, instead of reacting emotionally to situations, you will have an understanding of who people are emotionally. So when you are with your lover, when you are with someone and you happen to see your lover out with another person, you don't jump to conclusions so quick. You can save your relationship from drama, from stress, from anxiety, from jealousy, from grief, from envy. You can save your relationships from these type of emotions that down spirals your relationship and it gets you and your partner nowhere. You can save your relationships if you begin to start understanding who you are emotionally, how you are experiencing the world. You are experiencing the world through sight. You're experiencing the world through sight, emotionally. So watch this. Let's create another scenario. Let's say you see someone abusing a dog. Let's say you see someone abusing a pet. Let's say you see someone abusing a child. What are you going to do? You emotionally react, because what we see is triggering our emotions. What we see triggers our emotions. And if you are looking at your significant other, or you're seeing a pet abuse, an animal abuse, or you're seeing a child abuse, you will know how to react responsibly instead of react emotionally. Did you hear what I just said? You will learn how to react responsibly. Most people, I'll give you a story. I remember one time, and I'm going back because I'm going into a personal story of mine, because it was something that, you know, is real in my life, and I had to deal with situations before. And so I remember my stepfather and his girlfriend was having an argument, and my sister was around for the argument. One of my sisters, I have six sisters, and one of my sisters was around for the argument. I wasn't there, but my sister was. And my sister took my dad's side, and she started to get in my dad's personal business with his girlfriend. And so my sister started to jump down the throat of my dad's girlfriend, calling her names, yelling at her, screaming at her, ready to fight her for no real reason at all. And so my dad took his girlfriend's side. Here's my sister taking my dad's side because my dad and his girlfriend is having an argument. My sister takes his side, but my dad takes his girlfriend's side and begins to get in between his girlfriend and my sister as they were about to fight. So my dad's in the middle of them about to break it up. Long story short, my sister calls my mom. My mom is unaware of what's really going on because she's not there. But my mom calls me up. My mom was on the phone screaming and yelling, Marcus, hurry up and get down there. Hurry up, hurry up. I said, get where? What's happening? She says, hurry up and get over your dad's house. I said, why? She said, because your dad is holding your sister down while his girlfriend is beating on her. when I showed up to the scene of my dad and his girlfriend and my sister, I did not find that to be true. But when I got there, because of my mom and the way she acted emotionally, triggered me emotionally. So I didn't go there seeking understanding, and I didn't go there looking to solve the problem responsibly. I went there with a 2x4 in my hand, ready to swing it. And this was the first time ever in my life that I've ever raised my hand at my stepdad. I never did this ever before. But it was a moment that was happening because of emotional triggers. My mom is being emotionally triggered because my sister was emotionally triggered. My dad was emotionally triggered. It down spiraled all the way to me, to where my mom called me up, told me to get over there. I got over there. I showed up with a 2x4 in my hand, not knowing that the police was already called. And when I showed up there with a 2x4 in my hand, seeking no understanding, not showing up to solve the problem responsibly, by the time I got there with a 2x4 in my hand, the police showed up. They jumped out of their cars. I had the 2x4 on my shoulder like it was like I was Babe Ruth getting ready to swing a bat and hit a home run. I had the 2x4 ready to swing it at my dad because I see him arguing with my sister. And my dad's a big man. He's about 6'5", 250. And so I got this 2x4 ready to swing it at my dad. The police shows up just in time to stop me. They jumped out the car. They drew their guns on me. And they told me to drop my weapon. And when I dropped my weapon, they put me in handcuffs and put me in the back of the squad car, took me down to the county jail, and booked me into the police precinct for aggravated assault. Now, my dad did not press charges, but that aggravated assault charge still shows up on my record today. Why? Because emotionally showing up irresponsibly. And so the emotional triggers by what one was seeing, what my mom was hearing from what my sister was going through, what I saw when I got there, did me no justice at all. So I got booked into the police precinct with an aggravated assault charge. My dad dropped the charges. But at the same time, I had to deal with the grief and the guilt of raising my hand in this 2x4, getting ready to swing it at this man who had raised me as a son. I never ever did that in my life. I felt bad for doing that. Now, looking back at that, I now know how to emotionally respond to situations again if ever that was to happen. Will I show up with a 2x4 in my hand? Most likely not. The fact of the matter is what we see triggers us emotionally. And if we want to build holistic relationships, if we want to know how to master holistic relationships, we got to learn how to not react irresponsibly from our emotions in what we are seeing. This is going to take you very far. Now, I show up responsibly to situations that are out of hand. And 9 times out of 10, I don't get that phone call anymore because I've learned how to master my relationships. I've learned how to master healing relationships, holistic relationships around me, where I don't have to worry about getting phone calls like that because people know not to bother me with that anymore. Why? Because I am not on that level anymore. I am not in that place in my life where I will raise a 2x4, where I should have to raise a 2x4 to anybody. And if I ever have to raise a 2x4 to anybody, it's only going to be because of self-defense. But I won't do it because emotional charges and emotional triggers and emotionally irresponsibly reacting. That to me won't happen again. So guess what? You can master your holistic relationships emotionally when you don't react to things emotionally. Start to look at things holistically. See them in a pure way first. If you start to look at things and see things in a pure way first. Now, can you see a pet being abused in a way pure? Absolutely not. You can find pure solutions in how to deal with someone abusing a child or abusing an animal. You can go to a pure place and come from your emotional self pure and get pure, healthy, responsible results. If not from the person you're addressing, at least from you. And that's what you want. And so now, we're learning how to master spiritual by what? Being aware spiritually of who we are, and then seeing things holistically or seeing things pure. So we begin to see things more pure or from a pure state. And then we start to move toward the next thing, which is our biological. Our biological sense is going to be attached to touch. Why is our biological sense attached to touch? Because everything you need to understand is vibrating on a minute level. I can go deep about this, but I won't. Everything is vibrating on a minute level, beloved. And when you begin to understand that everything is vibrating on a minute level, that means everything is communicating. Everything you touch is communicating. So when you begin to touch things, you're getting a signal from that. Anything you touch, you're getting a signal from it. It's communicating. And what is communicating is translating information. I'm going to say that again. What is communicating is translating information. So if you are looking at what's being translated through touch, you will begin to understand what you are by what's being communicated to you. So if you are looking at certain things being communicated to you, what's being communicated to you, you would ask? Well, when you touch your children, you may get a good feeling from that. That feeling that you're getting from touching your children is a great response of love. This is why we love hugs. This is why people love hugs. Why do people love hugs? Because hugs are communicating something good to our vibrational field, our DNA. Hugs are communicating. Communication is translating information into our biological state of being. So when we understand who we are in a biological sense, then we will know what we want translated as far as communication goes into our biological state of being. I'll only operate, work with, communicate with people on a physical level, those who are communicating good, healthy, holistic, loving, positive responses to me. I'm only going to operate and communicate with people on that level. Because everything's vibrating on a minute level. So I am attracting what I am. I am attracting through vibration what I am. People find themselves connected to me on a biological level because of what I am on a biological level. I understand all things are communicating to me. And because all things are communicating to me on a biological level, then those who communicate and speak the same language as I find themselves in partnership and relationships with me because we speak the same communication language on a biological level. We understand what's being translated within and we know what we want to be translated out. So we are communicating from our internal to our external world. Not from what is external entering in, but what is internal exiting out. And that means that I put great things in my environment so that they communicate to me. Things like plants, things like natural herbs and natural oils, natural essential fragrances that speaks to my mind, speaks to my body. It's speaking. I put pictures on my wall that speaks to me. Everything is communication. So everything is speaking to me on a biological level. It's transforming my DNA. And so what transforms my DNA begins to transform my communication language and what's coming out of me. So I begin to speak holistically, which then attracts and vibrates to me those who live and speak on a holistic level with themselves. So what is being translated out is because what I put in my environment, what I am putting in my surrounding atmosphere, so that it speaks back to me, and that what speaks to me, communicates to me, I'm communicating that out. I'm communicating that to the world. I'm communicating good energy, positive vibrations to the world. And my people, my family, my tribe, my soul members are finding their way to me, are getting attracted to me and to my message because of what I understand on a biological level of who I am. My children are communicating to me. When I see them, it makes me smile. It changes my biological responses. It changes my biological DNA. It just changes everything about who I am. It changes all of me. It changes all of what I am. And so when you are putting great things in your environment that speaks back to you, so that what comes out of you is whole, is complete, is pure, is loving, is positive. When you speak those holistic things, you're going to attract holistic relationships. This is the mastery of building holistic relationships. When you are building masterful relationships, it's only because you are aware of who you are, you are seeing things more pure, and you are surrounding yourself with things that are good, okay? And this is how your holistic relationships are being formed. You may not know this on a minute level. You may not know this on a microcosm level, but on a macrocosm level, everything that is happening in your environment is because what's happening on a microcosm level is what's happening on a minute level. You need to start to see and understand who you are on a minute level first, which is internally. Understanding your well-being self, your whole self, your the well-being, this state of well-being, or the five states of well-beingness, is your spiritual, emotional, physiological, biological, and mental. And so now you have a sense of who you are on a biological level, surrounding yourself with the things that are good, so that you are putting that back out in the universe. And you are attracting to you through those vibes your tribe. Now we go into building holistic relationships through the mental aspect. What we are experiencing on a mental level is through our taste sensories. You may say, well, wow, how is that happening? How is that happening to us? How are we sensing things in the mental through our taste? Through the mental, you are tasting things. You say, how is that happening? How does that happen? Well, think about this. Let's create another visual scenario. Have you ever been at a restaurant sitting down eating? You may be looking at the menu. When you're looking at that menu, what's happening when you see the waiter come out with a plate of food getting ready to serve someone else? You look at it, and already you know what it tastes like. How do you know what it tastes like? Mentally, you are eating your food. This is why so many people are addicted to food. This is why so many people are dealing with obesity and illnesses in the body, because they see food. This is why do you think commercials like McDonald's, why do you think commercials like Burger King, why do you think these type of commercials put out these ads that they do? Because they understand if they can get into your subconscious mind, they first have to get into your conscious mind. And you become addicted to food subconsciously because of ads like McDonald's fed you through the conscious mind. I'm going to say that again. You are getting addicted to food on a subconscious mental level through what these McDonald's ads are doing to you on a conscious mental level. Your conscious mind, are you experiencing food? Through your conscious mind, are you experiencing what you eat? Through your conscious mind, are you experiencing? And so everything is mental through taste. We are tasting what that relationship would be like if I was in a relationship. When you see someone that you are, you, this is how people become obsessed with celebrities, and they see, oh my God, they look at Denzel Washington and say, ooh, if I could just kiss his lips. Mentally, you are experiencing the sensation, the feeling of kissing on Denzel Washington's lips. People are getting a sense of a charge mentally by experiencing through taste what it would be like to just be in the presence, to taste his energy, taste his aura, taste what he is like. I want to understand him mentally. You are tasting people mentally. And so this is why I've had a problem with people who find me online and they get so hip to my studies, to my teachings, that all they want to do is jump in my inbox and immediately try and become friends with me, buddies with me, comrades with me, and make a connection with me because they are experiencing me mentally through my teachings that they find online. They are tasting in their spirit what it would be like to be in the presence of this man and just taste his mind some. I want to taste his thinking. I want to taste what he's actually like to be around. So we are experiencing on a mental level taste. Your relationships are built through the mental aspect of what you think that person's presence would taste like to you. Being in their presence, you are tasting them and you are experiencing them through taste. Like, wow, I wonder what it would be like to be in their presence. McDonald's sells you ads and mentally you get caught up in the ads and you are eating their food on a mental level because they got in your conscious mind with the advertisement. And the same thing that happens to you at a restaurant when you're sitting down getting ready to order food, the waiter walks by you with someone else's food and you're looking at their food and mentally you already imagine what it would taste like, and all of a sudden, you want to order what they got. And you say to your waiter, I want to have what they're having. Because you're looking over at the next table, you're seeing what they're eating, and you're thinking through your mind, that food tastes good. And guess what? It may taste good to them. But then you get the food, and it become a bad experience for you. And so you are rushing into your decisions. You are rushing into your relationships. You're rushing into making decisions with relationships by what people are advertising to you. People are advertising to you what they are on social media, and you look at that and you think that this is who they are because you're tasting them mentally and you're thinking, oh, I accept who this person is, and your relationships become a bad experience. This is why you say what? Oh, that person left a bad taste in my mouth. Ooh, what does it mean when they leave a bad taste in your mouth? When they leave a bad taste in your mouth, it is because you are experiencing them on a conscious level, a mental level. And you say, that person left a bad taste in my mouth. And you can see someone's pictures online, and you can say that about them online. Not having been in their presence, you can say, this person leaves a bad taste in my mouth. What do you mean by that? You can already, that means you can already see mentally what it would be like to be in that person's presence. You can already see mentally what it would be like to be in the presence of that person. You can already see what it would be like mentally, what it would be like to have a relationship or be in a relationship with this person. You are experiencing people mentally. And when you are experiencing them mentally, what you're doing is when that experience becomes a bad one, you turn around and say, Man, don't work with him, man. She left a bad taste in my mouth. Don't work with them. They left a bad taste in my mouth. This company left a bad taste in my mouth. I would never work with them again. Because mentally, you thought they were something that they weren't. And you got an experience from them that you did not like. Mentally, you thought they were something that they weren't. And mentally, you got a bad experience. You taste the experience. You ever heard Taste the Rainbow from the commercial Skittles? Taste the Rainbow? Can you actually taste the rainbow? No. But the Skittles commercial makes you think that through eating Skittles, you are tasting the rainbow. Skittles make you believe that through eating Skittles, you're tasting the rainbow. And so you say, wow, I am actually tasting the rainbow when I eat a pack of Skittles. So they put the rainbow on a package of the Skittles, and you think mentally you're eating the rainbow. But you're eating a high sugary, high fructose corn syrup candy with all the bad preservatives and additives in it. And you don't even know that you're not eating the rainbow. You're eating something bad. And you say, taste the rainbow. The rainbow, the commercial Skittles say, taste the rainbow. And you go buy Skittles because it says, taste the rainbow. Because you had a mental experience with tasting the rainbow. So you want Skittles. And you keep thinking that, oh, I'm tasting the rainbow actually. But you're not. You're not actually tasting the rainbow. You're tasting high sugary foods. That is bad for you. And this is how you're building bad relationships. Because you're tasting what they're selling you mentally. You're tasting what people are selling you mentally. The ideal here is to not taste everything someone sells you through their advertisements. On a social media level, on a commercial level, on a mental level, on an advertisement level. Stop eating what people are selling you on a mental level. People are selling you something that they're not. But you bought into it because you have a mental experience with this person. And you think on a subatomic level, this relationship is going to be a holistic one. But it's not. It's not going to be a holistic relationship regardless of how you see it. Regardless of how you may think it is going to be, but it's not. So now you got to begin to shift your mindset and say, whoa. I'm not about to just jump into something with you. Let me experience who you are. Just because you present something that looks like it tastes good, I'm not just going to eat up what you serve. I'm not going to eat what you serve to me just because it looks good on a platter. I am going to experience on a mental level what it's like to be in a relationship with you before I make a critical judgment of who you are and before I make a crucial judgment irresponsibly of jumping into this relationship not knowing who you are because of what you present to me. I want to experience you on a mental level by experiencing you on a present level. Let me get present with you. And then let me experience what you have to offer me. Let me understand your mind. I remember when I used to be out there speaking in the motivational speaking platforms before COVID. And I would put my resume out there to these organizations so I could speak. And they would ask me to send them all kinds of resumes and people I spoke for and people I would present for and things I've presented. And I would do that. I would send them all of my documents, all of my information. But the fact of the matter is that what I was selling them, I was selling them who I was, who I was sure of I was, but they wasn't about to just buy into who I say I was just because on a mental level, everything looks good. Oh my God, I love your pictures. Oh my gosh, I love you spoke for this person and you spoke for that person. Wow, that's big. That's huge. That didn't mean they were going to bring me in. They still needed to get to understand my mind. They wanted to get to taste me in the presence of their being so they can say, okay, let's move forward with this relationship. Because they've tasted me being in my presence. They taste me on a mental level. They got to see me. They got to experience me. And they got to think for themselves who I am on a mental level by looking at me through looking at what's coming out of my mind. Did you hear what I just said? They got to experience me on a mental level, being in the presence of them by looking at what comes out of my thinking process, my thought process, my mind. So when they do that, they'll decide, okay, I'll move forward on this relationship because I'm loving what's coming out of your mind, meaning I'm loving what you're serving me and what I am eating up as mental nourishment. I'm loving what I'm eating up as mental nourishment. So now we can go forward with this relationship. To master holistic relationships, you got to be aware of what people are serving you, not through social media and their platforms, and not through what they are presenting to you through advertisements and commercials. What are they selling you? Get in their presence and ask them to serve you up something good for you to eat. Okay? That's how you build holistic relationships on a mental level. Lastly, you are experiencing your external world internally through the physiological sense. And how are we doing that? Well, through our hearing. Hearing is how we are being transformed physiologically. Your physiological state of well-being is the part of you where you hear something and you may get scared. You hear something and you may get excited. You hear something. You ever heard some exciting news? What happens when you hear exciting news? It changes your chemical state, your physiological state of being. It changes you chemically, which changes your physiological state. So what happens when you hear someone's getting married? Your best friend is getting married. What happens? Oh my God. Oh my God. Susie, guess what? I'm getting married next year. Oh my God. That's so exciting. I'm so happy for you. Mom, guess what? Mom, guess what? What? I just got accepted to Yale University. Oh my God. That's so great. That's so good, son. I'm happy for you. I'm excited for you. The way someone is feeling on a chemical level, on a physiological level, they may share that news with you. They are changing your chemical state of being, your physiological state of being. You heard good news, and good news changed your state of being. You heard bad news, and it changes your state of your physiological state of being. Why? Because what we hear changes our chemical responses, which changes our physiological state, which communicates to our brains how to feel. We think emotional is how we feel. Physiological is how we feel. Because the physiological state of being is what's sending the communication, the information to your brain to then process how to feel emotionally. So we are sensing through the physiological, from the chemical changes that is happening from something that we heard. So whatever we hear from sound, if we hear something good chemically that changes our physiological state, that thus sends chemical responses to our brains, serotonin, and it begins to change how we feel because of how we began to feel on a physiological state through what we heard. We feel emotionally through what we hear physiologically. So on a physiological level, we are hearing something that triggers us on how to feel. And so you may get some good news from your son being accepted to Yale University. You may get some good news that you've been promoted at your job. You may get some good news that you just hit the lottery. You may get some good news that you just got a big package in the mail from, a gift from someone, and you will begin to change your physiological state of being through hearing of this good news and vice versa. Hearing bad news changes your chemical state, which changes your physiological state of being and triggers you on how to feel emotionally. So you got to be aware. I always tell my staff, do not bring me bad news. Do not bring me bad news. Why? Because I don't need you to bring me news that is going to change how I begin to feel. I may be in a state of being where I'm feeling super good. And then you bring me the bad news, and then that begins to change my chemical responses and changes my feeling physiologically. because you said something, you told me something I heard. Now it sends chemical responses to my brain, which begins to change my physiological state of being. Now I'm feeling sad and blue all day long. I cannot get this feeling out of me. Why? Because you told me this. I've heard this news and it's too late. Now it got into my physiological being and it's lodged itself into my state of being. Now I cannot unhear that. Now I have to do all kinds of meditation, all kinds of sound healing to change my vibrational state of being so that I begin to introduce the positive signs, introduce the good vibrations, and introduce the spiritual well-being sounds of hearing something good be introduced back into my state of being. So I tell my staff, don't bring me any bad news. I don't want bad news. Only bring me good news. I actually tell them, only bring me good news, because that's all I want to hear. Now, if I have to hear bad news because it's something that I must hear, then I'll hear it. But I'm not going to allow it to change how I feel on a physiological level. My relationships are a direct response of what I feel. And I feel not through emotion. It is through how I feel which triggers my emotion. Your emotions is sad, happiness, joy, anxiety, grief, guilt, fear, sorrow, self-pity, compassion. These are emotions. But what is triggering me on how to feel sad or how to feel happy is what triggered me in what I heard on a physiological state, on a physiological state of being, which triggered chemical signals to the brain, thus communicating, translating, and telling my emotional state on how to feel. I am feeling first through sound. I'm feeling through sound. So if you hear a gunshot go off in the movie theater, I'm sorry to use this type of scenario, visual scenario, but if you hear a gunshot go off in a closed space, what are you going to do? Immediately, fear overcomes you. Immediately, frighten overcomes you. Immediately, worry overcomes you. Immediately, anxiety overcomes you. Because the sound that is related to a gunshot, unfortunately, is fear or anxiety, high stress. These things are related to the sound. Your sound and what you're hearing is related to your physiological state of being. So if you want to master holistic relationships, beloved, begin to control what is being introduced to your hearing so that what you are exiting out of your state of being on a physiological sense is something good, something positive, something nourishing. If you want to build holistic relationships, beloved, transform what is introduced to you, what enters in, so that what exits out is that which is good, that which is healing, that which has produced great results. You want to produce great results? Change what you're hearing. You want to change people's feelings and the way they feel, and you want to speak good? Change what you are introducing and entering into your physiological state. What's entering through the ear gate? What's entering in through what you're hearing? You can master holistic relationships by controlling what you hear. What comes in to your hearing field? Because what comes in through your hearing field is actually what you're feeling on a physiological state. A gunshot goes off, you feel frightened, fear, worry, anxiety. You start looking around for the next exit, because that's what a gunshot is related to. You are experiencing people in your relationships on a physical, on a physiological level, because what you are hearing. And so your relationships could be good relationships. If you are putting out good, then what comes back to you is good. Because I talked about earlier in the show that everything is vibrating on a minute level. Everything is communicating, translating, and transforming your DNA. If you change what you're hearing, you'll change what you're saying. If you change what you're hearing, you'll change what you're saying. And what you're saying will begin to change your relationships, because you'll begin to attract that in those who are of your vibrational field. Those who are of your universe. Those who communicate the same language. You will begin to transform who you are through this way of seeing yourself on a physiological state of being. And then your relationships will begin to transform, because if you put out good, you will begin to attract good. But not just that. If you put out good through what you say, then what you say will begin to come back to you in a holistic way on a physiological level from others speaking your language. And so this is why you hear people say, oh, she's speaking my language. Because you're feeling them. You're feeling the words they're saying on a physiological state of being. Because of what they're saying, it's changing the chemical responses in your brain, sending signals to you on an emotional level, which is changing how you emotionally feel. Happy, sad, joyful, down in blue. It is changing how you feel because of what you're hearing. So you say things like, oh man, she's speaking my language. Oh, he's speaking my language. Oh, that person is speaking my language. Why would they be speaking your language? Because you're hearing something that is related to who you are. You are hearing someone speak in relation to who you are. You're feeling that physiologically. So you say, they are speaking my language. They are speaking the language I speak. So begin to transform your relationships by transforming what you say. And what you say will begin to transform back to translate back to you who you are. And those relationships will begin to heal you on a holistic level, because you're only attracting who you are through what you say on a physiological level. And what you say on a what you say comes from the physiological state of being. And those people who are attracted to you will begin to speak the language you speak, and they thus will become those who are of your holistic tribe, your holistic relationships that you are building. Because they're feeding back to you the nourishment, the good, the great, the well-being, elevating, raising, and uplifting your consciousness, uplifting your state of thinking, elevating and raising your vibrational field on a minute level, being more, making you more, helping you become more aware of who you are. When you do this, beloved, you are mastering holistic relationships. So begin to start with knowing who you are on an internal level. And these are your state of well-being: spiritual, mental, emotional, physiological, biological. I would recommend one book for you to read today. And that's what I'll do. At the end of all my shows, I'll begin to recommend a book that you must read. I'm going to be recommending books for the sake that you study these books and that you get deeper into more of who you are holistically and begin to study yourself on a minute and on a macro level. And I want you to start to raise your vibration. That's what this show is about: self, health, and well-being. I would recommend books for you to do that. And that book is Bioenergetics by Alexander Lowen. Go and study this book, Bioenergetics. It's the revolutionary therapy that uses the language of the body to heal the problems of the mind. If you study this book, it will transform your life on an internal level so you could transform people and those around you on an external level. And I want to say, so long, be well, and be light, beloved. Until the next time, see you right back here on the Center of the SOHL Podcast.
Songbird. If we don't have no loving, how we supposed to?